Hi, I'm Ethan Grimes. The Road is a film that focuses on survival and morality. These words mean nothing by themselves. Their meaning comes from many places and details in the work that we'll delve into to figure out what it all meant. The Road is not so much about the triumph of the human spirit as it is about the will to survive for a better life for oneself or for another. Being essentially a road trip movie through an almost desolate post-apocalyptic landscape, The Road features uniform destruction or decay due to lack of sunlight and constant earthquakes. The lighting choices, along with the general color palette falling into grays and earth tones, consistently feeds us this information, even indoors. Seeing our leads wandering through the environment, exhausted, dirty, and paranoid, adds to our understanding of where the world has fallen and how strong their resolve must be. Even if you strip the film of exposition,
the roads are peopled by refugees towing carts and gangs carrying weapons, looking for fuel and food.
The very fact that these people are still alive and wake up every day to this world says everything you need to know about their will. A gloomy attitude still persists, and is something we as the audience soak in. One of the earliest scenes in the film includes the man teaching the son how to kill himself so he doesn't feel any pain or unwanted sexual advance.
Okay.
Like this.
No.
You just pull the trigger. You got it.
The film continues with sequences of this general attitude evenly throughout, coating the film in a dire veneer. In the vein of a run-of-the-mill black comedy that highlights extreme humor in the face of general depravity, The Road highlights extreme positivity in the face of general sorrow. Juxtaposition is a powerful tool, in this case, making positive moments an absolute delight.
Shampoo.
Shampoo.
We sympathize with how wonderful these moments are in contrast, and thus begin to understand the man's plight. He hopes, beyond reason itself, that there is a better world on the horizon, and that one day his son will get to maintain the heights of moments like this.
Mm. Huh?
It's really good.
As commonplace.
You should have some.
No, you drink it.
I want you to have some.
He retains standards, though. It's not enough to have and be healthy, but to be genuinely safe from the world, even if it means leaving a veritable oasis to avoid risk.
We'll just have to take what we can.
You always think bad things are gonna happen, but we found this place.
The film also makes it a point to show someone without this will. The wife, in flashbacks, is used as a vessel for the antithesis of this attitude.
No, I don't want to do this. What kind of life is this?
She doesn't want any suffering and doesn't see the possible, however slight, better life for her child. After a time, she can't bear existence itself and gives in.
But she died somewhere in the dark. There is no other tale to tell.
Her lack of resolve works to, one, ground the story in believability, even mirroring possible audience opinion.
I should have done it a long time ago. I should have done it when we had more.
And two, give counterpoint to the narrative itself.
We have to. We will survive this. We are not gonna quit. We're not gonna quit.
I don't want to just survive.
She highlights the hope the father feels, and the adaptability of such a young person in this situation. It's not enough to survive, though. Simply put, morality is one of the most easily attained or sustained attributes that gives us a life, as opposed to an existence based on survival alone.
Sometimes I tell the boy old stories of courage and justice, difficult as they are to remember. All I know is the child is my warrant, and if he is not the word of God, then God never spoke.
It's a part of what separates us from the animal kingdom and reflects our rational thought. Our protagonists look down upon giving into evil.
There's been cannibalism. Cannibalism is the great fear.
Defined as acts against the assumed previous society's morality, in this case. If flashbacks are used to give us antithesis, the story structure is used to compare and contrast. Through parsing the story out in vignettes, it lets us judge our main characters with others we see through their travels. In one encounter, we see survival tactics take the form of murder and thievery, against the hesitation of violence from the man.
Come on. I ain't going nowhere.
You think I won't kill you?
In another, we see what the film believes is one of the worst survival instincts, cannibalism. Alongside an explanation of why it's bad from our protagonist's point of view.
We would never eat anybody, would we?
No, of course not.
Because we're the good guys.
Yes.
And we're carrying the fire.
In yet another, we see violence-free theft and the rationalization of lesser crime.
Please, mister. You ain't gotta do this.
And mercy. From discussing beliefs with wary travelers,
and whoever made humanity will find no humanity here. No, sir. No, sir.
To killing out of mistake.
Why are you following us?
Following anybody? Following us.
We were asked to consider ramifications of every action.
We're gone.
What do you want me to do?
Just help him, Papa. Just help him.
And whether or not they make someone less human or lack morality.
He's gonna die.
He's gonna die anyway.
I'm so scared.
I'm scared. You understand? I'm scared.
If more directly crafted or less ambiguity were used, this could have led us to believing the man as a paragon, but another route was taken. In the end, the man dies of an unknown disease, while the son gets to have a new family, a better life than what could have been. How we view this is on us as individuals. Is it random that the man died? Was it his comeuppance? Did he achieve his goal unwittingly? Will the son be okay? Is there any real reasoning to anything? These are questions for us to ponder, same as the general morality play at work throughout the film.
Are you carrying the fire?
You know what?
Carrying the fire.
There are no stark beliefs. Just our judgment over characters and events.
I'm so glad to see you. We were following you, did you know that? We saw you with your papa. We're so worried about you. Now we don't have to worry about them.
Instead of giving us direct reasoning and a solid theme, the road works as an experience. We live in this world with this dire attitude and sympathize for those in it. Regardless of their choices. We are meant to ask ourselves what survival, morality, and another person's life means to us, inside the scenario and out. Thank you.